you dare say goodbye. The truth goes on forever, but the world is one big lie. It is cunning and it's clever. It is trouble. For something better, 'cause the days they are waning.
Now the days they are waning, and we're all thick as thieves, holding on to one another, and we die by degrees. And there are those who left to wander, feeling so ill at ease. They will tremble to the thunder, 'cause the days they are waning. Hold on, baby, hold on, baby.
Justin Patterson. We are Ten Penny Gypsy and so excited to have you join us for our monthly songwriter showcase, Sounds of Unity.
Yeah, excited about this one tonight. Absolutely. Erin Enderlin is our guest tonight. And Erin is a singer-songwriter from Nashville that is putting together a stellar career over there, writing hits for other people. She's also obviously her own career, performing career, is really taking off. And she is the most decorated artist in Arkansas Country Music Awards history.
I'm a little starstruck. I got to sit by her at the Arkansas Country Music Awards the year that Buddy Case was nominated, or actually won, the Guitar Player of the Year. So we got to rub elbows during the show.
Well, hey, she is great, and we can't wait to bring her to you a little bit later.
That's right.
We've also got Cliff Prowse down here. Cliff, what's going on, man?
He still has the microphone.
Cliff would tell you everything that's going on in the world of Cliff and Susan, Big Red Dog Productions, Yadaloo. He would tell you all that if he had a microphone.
That's right. They're set up and ready to play at Oaklawn tonight, as they often do. Catch their show anytime you can. Check in with them, Cliff and Susan. They're some of our favorite artists. So, and you know, they've been promoting us and helping us keep Sounds of Unity going since March of 2020. So that's right. We love having Cliff play with us. We just didn't tell him to be prepared to sing today, too.
Cliff, if you want to sing, just yell and we'll move everything over.
There you go.
Hey, here's a song from our Fugitive Heart album, which was back in 2020. And it's a little song called The Train Won't Wait For Me.
Thank you.
running down the back road. There's a place I gotta be. I've a need to go much faster. The train won't wait for me. I got a wasted disposition and a suitcase in my hand and a need for tender mercy, redemption on demand. Hey, you tell me there's a place where I'll be free. Baby, that old train won't wait for me. It won't wait for me. It won't wait for me. It's a long way to the station and a go against the grain. Sometimes I get so restless, restless like a train. But every love in danger will surely slow me down. There's a train that leaves tomorrow, and I'll be lucky if I'm around. Hey, you tell me there's a place where I'll be free. Baby, that old train won't wait for me. It won't wait for me. It won't wait for me.
Feel that way, like life is just moving a little bit faster than you can hang on to.
Oh yeah.
I can't say how much we have appreciated your support since April of 2017. We've been showcasing local Arkansas talent and performing and songwriting talent, and I've had this wonderful man by my side since then. You know, you don't always know what's going on in his life. You always know what's going on in my life because I tell him. But your dad's been in and out of the hospital lately, and you've been up there supporting your parents. And
yeah, we've been struggling with aging parents, like I know a lot of people out there have. And you know, the train won't wait for me. The first song we did called "The Waning Days." Yeah. That's a brand new song, and I know it's got to be kind of inspired by everything that's going on, you know, not just in our families, but in our world. So, hey, songwriting is the great salve to all of this. And we've got a great, great, great songwriter coming up a little bit later. Miss Erin Enderlin, as we said.
One of my favorite portions, I may not have told you this, but every month one of my favorite portions that developed over the years was you interviewing our artists. So I'm extra excited to hear you interview Erin Enderlin today.
Oh, so. Yeah. We got pretty in-depth. It was pretty cool. So we look forward to that. You're getting ready to go out of town. Tell us where you're going and what's happening.
You know how much I like to travel. I do have roots, finally. I bought a house in 2019. But anyway, I love to be on the road, as you know. And in last year, 2021, I was driving home from a girlfriend weekend and was on a back road of Arkansas, past this man, his smile just reached out and grabbed me. His name is British Sterling Malone II. He's on a peace walk across America. Look him up, find him. Since then, since last summer when I met him, he has walked another 2,100 miles, more than that.
He's on the West Coast now.
He's almost Portland.
About to finish. So you're going to go help him finish?
I am. I'm going to go out on Tuesday, hopefully, and join him and help him finish the walk. We're going to end up in Seattle, have a little skate party and a celebration for. He started in Florida.
Yeah.
And I would love it if y'all want to come out and join us, do that. And if you can't be there in person, like I said, find him on Facebook, on probably Twitter, but I know Instagram and TikTok, and just send him some love. See what he needs to finish his walk.
He's also a great cinematographer, and he surprised us with a great video from one of our songs from our first album. It's on our website. It's the Perfectly Imperfect video. He did that.
That's right.
And so he's just a really talented guy. Laura's going to go support him.
Yeah, he did surprise me. He took some time out of the walk last July in the heat in Okmulgee, Oklahoma, and we shot that amazing video, and I'm grateful to him. So
you know, every time you go out of town, I like, not every time, but I tend to write songs when she's gone about her leaving, you know. So, but it's the West Coast this time. It's not Mexico, but last time she went to Mexico, I wrote this song from our Fugitive Heart album, and this is me bearing my heart of how I feel when Laura leaves town. Where is my darling, the one I hold so true? She left before daybreak, how can I make it through? They say there was a beauty on a bus leaving town, making straight for the border, never once slowing down. She's on the Mexico flyer and she's just out of range. Left me on fire saying I'll never change. If only, my darling, I could chase you that far. It costs more than the money in my old mason jar.
They say old Campeche about this time of year is the beyond and the end of keeping my head clear.
I could chase you that far. It costs more than the money in my old mason jar. Just 2 days' time. Well, I'm not up to the challenge, and
down to my last time. Light gets stuck down in Texas. It's a bad lot I drew. I'll have a 10-gallon heartache for every memory of you. She's on the Mexico flyer and she's just out of range. Left me on fire saying I'll never change. If only, my darling, I could chase you that far. It costs more than the money in my old mason jar. If only, my darling, I could chase you that far. It costs more than the money in my old mason jar.
That's what happens.
I mean, how can a girl not come home when you're writing her love songs?
That's what happens when you go like that.
I can hear your voice just out on the waves, calling me home. This is a song just about learning how to find your pace in life, but recommending you kind of slow it down, especially if you live in this beautiful, natural state of Arkansas. Take some time to wander those back roads, like where I met British. Just take in the beauty, all the mountains. Just all the beauty. And the beauty of these two playing. I live in silent hope, a natural state. And it's so beautiful, it gives me breath today. Long winding road. Anywhere I wanna go, so I take my time. I take it slow. And I already feel I'm moving way too fast. Might lose the wheel. So I Why is everybody rushing by? Thank you. everybody rushing by? Is everybody rushing by? Rushing by. Why is everybody rushing by? Is everybody rushing by? Silent hope, a natural state, and it's so beautiful, it gives you breath today. Long winding roads, anywhere you wanna go, so you take your time, you take it slow.
Laura Lynn Danley. I'm Justin Patterson with Ten Penny Gypsy. Thanks as always to Mr. Cliff Prowse.
Thank you so much, and thank you for tuning in every month. You'll notice some Susan. Thank you always for being here and supporting us. She'll be posting our Venmo, Cash App, PayPal, just different ways for you to support us financially so we can pay our artists well and keep bringing in people like Erin Enderlin.
Yeah.
I'm excited for your interview coming up.
Erin Enderlin is coming up right now. Thanks for joining us. Hey, everybody, welcome to Sounds of Unity. We are so happy to have Nashville singer-songwriter and touring artist Erin Enderlin with us.
Thanks for having me.
You bet. So a lot of stuff going on in the studio here.
Yep.
A little rehearsing going on for some local shows coming up, right?
Yeah, I'm playing a couple shows in Arkansas this weekend up in Huntsville and Russellville.
Awesome. Be on the lookout for that. We're going to give you some more information on that as the show goes on. Arkansas girl.
Yep.
Conway.
I was raised mostly in Conway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But you went to school in Nashville. You went to college.
Yeah, I went to college in Murfreesboro.
Yeah. And not that long after that, I'm just going to come out and say it, Alan Jackson put one of your songs in the top 10.
It was actually while I was in college.
Yeah, while you were in college.
I had that moment of coolness.
That is very cool. So besides feeling cool, I mean, that had to have been so gratifying to have that happen in a kind of a relatively short period of time as far as Nashville time.
Yeah,
goes.
I mean, it was really wild, and I mean, I feel really, really blessed to have had that because it doesn't always happen that way. And I got to go straight in from leaving school to writing full time and got a deal on a record label and got to start making music full time.
Right. So obviously, millions of talented people in Nashville. Mm-hmm. And you were one of them. But who did you lean on? Who were some people that took you under their wing to kind of guide you through the process of Nashville? Because it's not always an easy one, right?
Yeah, Walt Wilkins introduced me to a couple of publishers, Scott Gunner and Chris Oglesby, who were really great. And they kind of, they've done a lot of different cool stuff over the years, but they kind of had a mentor kind of program. I mean, it wasn't like an official program, but so I got to play them songs and hang out with them. And I also, Rick and Janice Carnes, who are some great writers in Nashville, they were the first folks to start writing with me up there.
Right.
And then Rory Feek wrote with me not long after that, too, and he's been a big supporter of mine. I've learned a lot from him.
Well, you know, it's the list of people that have recorded Erin's songs just continues to grow. I saw on a post that the legendary Gene Watson is getting ready to put a couple of your songs on his album. So that continues to grow. But you've also parlayed that into your own touring experience, your own singing your own songs and, you know, being an artist yourself. Was one dream bigger than the other?
You know, I started writing songs really, really young, and I don't think I really even completely understood it, maybe. I just did it.
Right.
And I never really thought about being a songwriter. I wanted to go out and play my own songs and doing that, and I just kind of got lucky enough to put my foot in that door. I mean, I don't think growing up, I definitely learned about songwriters and found out that was a thing.
Right.
But, you know, thinking back to, you know, 18, 18-year-old Erin, I don't know that I understood that whole process.
Sure.
But I was lucky enough to meet a couple of really great, great folks in the industry, publishers Reese Fall and Jeff Carlton, that I started working with just about 2 years after I moved to Nashville. And they really, they took a big gamble on me and spent a lot of time. And, you know, Jeff took a second mortgage out of his house to do demos on me and everything and start a new, brand new publishing company with me. It was called World House of Hits, so it was a lot of pressure just sure. to be a World House Hits all by yourself. But, you know, it was just a really great experience, and it was a wonderful time in my life because, yeah, I was just surrounded by live music all the time. I got to go out and watch and learn from artist showcasing to songwriter rounds to just the folks that you would meet and kind of start learning from and bouncing ideas off of and hearing and just getting to get up every day. And all I had to do was create and do whatever I wanted to do. It was pretty amazing.
Yeah, that's so cool. So your performing career has taken you to some really cool places.
Yeah.
I'm going to name some places and you tell me if you've played there or not, okay? Bluebird Cafe.
Yeah.
Okay. Country Music Hall of Fame.
Yep.
Grand Ole Opry.
Yep.
Yeah. See, those are all hallowed, the most hallowed ground of country music, and that's just so cool.
I've been really fortunate. I just, you know, I love it so much. And, you know, I think people see that, and just my love for it has taken me to a lot of places that ended up connections being made and stuff happening. So
let's take the Grand Ole Opry. Is the feeling that you thought you'd have when you dreamed it, was it that good a feeling?
That was my biggest dream growing up. And actually, I actually started working there quite a bit into my career. I was kind of having a little crisis of like, what am I going to do now? I'd been dropped from my record label, which, you know, was fun and all that kind of stuff. And was trying to figure out, like, I knew I still loved it, but I didn't know what I really needed to do and whatever. And so I was like, I'm going to get a job at the Grand Ole Opry. It was a very flexible schedule. I could still work, write, and do all that kind of stuff. But that's where I fell in love with country music. And so I thought it would take me back there, and it did. And it was so incredible, not only to watch all the different artists that come up, because to me, it's like, I mean, that's like artist school, because you get to see one artist after another do their thing. How do they connect with the crowd? How do they define their sound?
Right.
But then on top of that, I just love all the people I worked with. I worked with a lot of folks who'd been working there since the 70s, and they had great stories. And they were all huge supporters of mine, and I ended up, they made me quit so I could play for the first time, which was really funny. And I've gotten to play it 19 times now, and it's still,
that is so cool.
It's everything.
Really, yeah. So you love Arkansas. I can always tell because every time you come back, you're so gracious with your time. And Arkansas loves you back. We can talk about the Arkansas Country Music Awards. Erin is the most decorated artist in the history of the Arkansas Country Music Awards. I think the nominations are up in the 20s, and I'm not sure how many of those little things that you have.
12.
That's
pretty crazy.
That really is, but
I hope people don't start thinking I'm a jerk. I kind of
No, I mean, it's, you know, I started that sentence by saying it's, you know, you love Arkansas, and it shows. And so I don't think anybody thinks that way at all, but five of those are Songwriter of the Year awards. Mm-hmm. And so let's kind of circle back to the songwriting thing. You said that you're not sure exactly how all that started, exactly?
Well, I know how it started, but I don't know that I really understood what I was doing. I read an article that Reba McEntire, an interview she had given, and she was talking about after a show one night, I believe it was her mom, who said, "Well, you sounded like Loretta Lynn," and she was like, "Oh, that's great, thank you." And she was like, "Well, I mean, It's good, but you got to find out who Reba is, because there's already a Loretta Lynn.
Right.
And for some reason in my brain, I remember I was reading this at the Boys and Girls Club in Conway, Arkansas, and thought, well, if I start writing my own songs, no one will have ever sung them before, so I'll have to find my own voice in doing that.
Right.
So I just started writing songs and taking them to Miss Langford's music class and playing them for all the kids in there, and they looked at me like I had two heads. And it was great.
It's still strange where, I mean, you can't really place where your brain goes in the songwriting process. I can't. For instance, I grew up like an only child, right? So I had a lot of time to myself. And to me, songwriting is like, you know, is like a daydream, okay? You know, some people are observers of what's going on around them. To me, it's almost like a fiction, you know, being a fiction author, you know, because it's like a daydream. Some of it's a combination of all that. I'm sure that when you write songs for a living, that process kind of changes a little bit as far as where you get the inspiration. Because there's things you may have to write because people want to hear it. Is that true?
I've never been really good at that. I always try to keep challenging myself. And, you know, early on I started getting a lot of my cuts. Most of my cuts are ballads, and they're really right. Like the dark and twisty kind of stuff.
Right.
And I was writing other things, but I guess, you know, maybe that wasn't as strong in those areas. And I think maybe I dove more head on onto what I felt like my strengths were, because that seemed to be where I was getting the opportunities. But I did want to keep growing and doing other things like that, and just, you know, try to listen to other music that inspired me, you know, try to find, well, what tempo songs do you like? What songs, like recently, I don't know if you're familiar with Highway 101, right. But they have a song called Whiskey, If You Were a Woman, and I love that song. And so I went to a couple co-writers, and I was like, I love the feel of this song. It's so, you know, just like perfect, mid, like get the crowd going kind of thing. And I want to do something like that. And we wrote a song that I think exactly like, you know, little influence root shoot off of that song that I really am proud of, and right. And feel like it's challenged me. It was a different kind of write. It was my fault, I guess, but we wrote it for like, I don't know, 5 or 6 times we got together, because I really wanted it to be a certain thing. And I think that's different too now that I'm just like, I just want to write whatever I want to write. And I've always been kind of like that, but I'm even worse about it now. I'm like, I only want to write things I want to write and things that I want to cut as an artist. And if other people want to cut them, great. But
that's exactly kind of the feeling. I always, you know, kind of ask myself, could I, you know, write something on demand, because I'm such a daydream writer of just stuff that's up in my head. So, yeah, that's kind of interesting how that all works out, because it's kind of a combination of both things. It's your inspirations,
yeah,
plus your influences.
Yeah, and when I write with other artists, you know, sometimes that is a thing that kind of helps me go a different direction. And maybe I take more of an editor's slot, or let them be a little more of the lead or whatnot. And I've written a bunch of songs with like Sonny Sweeney and Terry Clark and folks that I love what they do. And I feel like, you know, we're kindred spirits.
Right.
So they definitely have a very strong voice in what they do. Like Terry's phrasing is crazy. I love phrasing. It's one of my favorite things. But she's very, very unique. And so it's fun to write with somebody and see how they put their own spin on things.
Sure. Absolutely. Arkansas Country Music Awards, we've kind of segued, you know, the Songwriter of the Year Awards that Erin has won. We always want to take time to shout out to Buddy Case, the 2021 Arkansas Country Music Awards Guitar Player of the Year. I'm sure Erin would join us in saying, Buddy, keep getting better, man. You're so important to Ten Penny Gypsy, so important to the Arkansas music scene. So keep getting better, Buddy Case.
Yeah, I love you, Buddy. We've known each other for a long, long time.
Yeah, goes way back. So as far as recording, what's your next plans there? What's coming out?
Well, it's interesting. I'm really excited about the time we're in, because I feel like as an independent artist, you have a lot of avenues to put music out. And So I'm doing a lot of different things right now. I've cut some individual tracks, and I may put some other things out this year. I'm looking at maybe doing a Christmas song for this Christmas. But I've got a record finished that I'm going to be putting out next spring. But I want to make sure that I have the time to put all the pieces in place, to put it out the right way. And but I'm really excited about it, and doing all kinds of other projects. You know, I've been so grateful to be out back on the road again this year and playing a lot of shows and getting to play some really cool places. And
so this next segment takes you from Arkansas, and then you said what, Texas, Louisiana?
So Arkansas, Texas. I can't remember which order. Oh, yeah, okay. Arkansas, Texas, Arkansas, Oklahoma, Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas, Tennessee.
Lots of chances to catch Erin Enderlin, for sure. We are so happy that you were gracious enough to talk to us and come play Sounds of Unity, because for Laura and I, Ten Penny Gypsy, this thing has come such a long way since it first started. And we always give a shout out to Cliff and Susan,
yes,
for keeping our dream alive. And now in this wonderful studio, we can't wait to see what you're playing for us tonight. And thank you for stopping in.
Oh, you know, it's been a really fun day, and, you know, I love to get to stop in and hang out with you.
Good. Erin Enderlin, everybody.
Just 15, way too young to know what love means. July heat, muscadine white, and the words you said made her cross a line. On a homemade quilt in the pale moonlight, he swore he'd love her till the day he died. Georgia pines, true love is the forever kind. The promises he made that night faded with the morning light. He just used her and he told her so, left her like trash at the side of the road. She alone would bear spring when the baby came. Caroline, a secret is the tie that binds. Caroline, you lay beneath the Georgia pines, true love is the forever kind. But a fire burned in the woods at night. She could see the blood soaking up his jeans, smelled like smoke and gasoline. Five bullets left in a six-shooter gun. She said, "Daddy, what have you done?" A true love is the forever kind.
Hey y'all, I'm Erin Enderlin, and I'm so excited to be here with you today to play a few tunes, and I thought the only right way to start off the show with was with a few murdering tunes. And here's one about my baby sister, or somebody's baby sister.
Please come to Boston, was playing on the radio. He asked me to go, I thought, what the hell? It's the same old story, ain't there always a man involved? Whole thing reeks of alcohol, somebody ends up in jail. You see, my sister Gina, she always was the pretty one, just like Audrey Hepburn and Breakfast at Tiffany's. She could have had any man, so I thought he was just another one. That no-tell motel shotgun epiphany. My baby sister, sweet baby sister, should have known blood is thicker than love. My baby sister, sweet baby sister, I knew you were a pistol, I never knew you owned a gun. She busted down the door, room 5 at the family inn, joyride to New England, ended with a bang. She said, wait till I tell mama, and shout out the TV set, crushed out a cigarette, turned the gun on Bobby Ray. My baby sister, sweet baby sister, should have known blood is thicker than love. My baby sister, sweet baby sister, I knew you were a pistol, I never knew you owned a gun. Well, I visit Gina upstate every Saturday. I bring her smokes and Gatorade, and we don't talk about Bobby Ray. My baby sister, sweet baby sister, show glad blood is thicker than love. My baby sister, sweet baby sister, I knew you were a pistol, I never knew you owned a gun.
This next song is off my Faulkner County album, and it's a love song, but it's not a first love song. It's more like maybe your 9th or 10th or 20th try it.
Floor every night, you come back for more. Order makers on ice, chase it with a lucky strike. I can be your whiskey, I can be your cigarette, you're trying to forget. If your loving cup needs filled up, you she left you bone dry empty. Baby, I can be your whiskey. My love's stronger than 90 proof. Just wait and see what one kiss can do. And if you think it's too good to believe, well, don't worry, baby, 'cause this round's on me. And I can be your whiskey, I can be your cigarette, I can drown that memory that you're trying to forget. If your loving cup needs filled up, she left you bone dry empty. Baby, I can be your whiskey. Baby, I can be your one more chance, your one more try. My love can get you so high. I can be your whiskey, I can be your cigarette, I can drown that memory that you're trying to forget. If your loving cup needs filled up, she left you bone dry empty. Baby, I can be your whiskey. Baby, I can be your whiskey.
This next song, I've been lucky enough, I moved to Nashville about 20 years ago, and I've been lucky enough to have some songs recorded by folks, and this one I had recorded by Luke Bryan.
He asked me for a dollar, I said go get a job, I turned up my collar, started walking on. He said, I don't blame you, I know what you think. I just spend your money to buy another drink. But you don't know, Jack, double shot, 80 proof on the rocks, still lost it all, and you can't go to your life and your kids and your ex-wife for just a telephone call. If you think it's just a bottle and that old brown paper sack, you don't know Jack. Well, he showed me a picture of two little girls wearing Easter dresses, hair done up in curls. He said, God bless their mama. She said, I couldn't stay. And honey, if you're wondering how I could throw it all away, you don't know, Jack, double shot, 80 proof on the rocks, still lost it all. So darling, just be tonight, hold your kids and your husband tight. And when you talk to God, count up all your blessings and thank the good Lord that you don't know Jack. You don't know Jack. If you've never felt a fire running through your veins, if you've never seen the devil face to face, you don't know Jack. double shot, 80 proof on the rocks till you've lost it all. So darling, just be glad. And tonight, hold your kids and your husband tight when you talk to God. Count up all your blessings and thank the good Lord that you don't know Jack. You don't know Jack.
This next song I was playing out in Kansas one summer, and luckily it was approximately 1.5 million degrees outside, and we were playing in a tent with no circulation. So I went out to walk around, find a little breeze, and I came across this woman who I'm pretty sure had it all figured out. She had a nice wide-brimmed hat on, sunglasses, a tall iced adult beverage, and a shirt on that said, "I'd rather be somebody's shot of whiskey than everybody's cup of tea." And that is a sentiment that I can get behind.
It's a blue ribbon morning after a black label night. I got kinda out of hand 'cause I was wound up a little too tight. But Jesus still loves me, even when I do the devil's ways. I'm just a honky-tonk angel with a little bit of hell to pay. But I'd rather be somebody's shot of whiskey, somebody's rough around the edge. At least I can sleep well tonight 'cause I stand behind the words I say. You can make everybody happy, that's all right by me. As long as my baby loves me all the way from A to Z, I'd rather be somebody's shot of whiskey than everybody's cup of tea. Well, all my life I've been told I'm cut from a different cloth. If I tried to hide it, it all come out in the wash. Oh, if I'm a little left to center, well, I really don't give a damn, 'cause I got all the friends I need. Take me just the way I am. And I'd rather be somebody's shot of whiskey, somebody's blue flame in the fire. Some are gonna see the rose, some are gonna see the bride. You can't make everybody happy, that's alright by me. As long as my baby loves me all the way from A to Z, I'd rather be somebody's shot of whiskey than everybody's cup of tea. Somebody's shot of whiskey than everybody's cup of tea. Yeah, I'd rather be somebody's shot of whiskey than everybody's cup of tea.
Well, this next song I wrote after my first trip to L.A. And about a year and a half ago, I got an email one morning, opened it up, and it was from Roseanne Cash. And she said, "Hey, somebody gave me a copy of your record and I really like it. hope you don't mind, I passed it on to my friend Elton. And I emailed her back and I said, first of all, you're Roseanne Cash. Second of all, you don't mean Elton John, do you? And she said, yeah, and he really likes it too. I think he wants to interview you. So if you look up Elton's Apple show, Rocket Hour, episode number 261 on Apple Music is titled Erin Enderlin. And this is the song that brought us together.
I used to live in L.A., right by the freeway. I stayed out all night, drank whiskey like wine, and lied about my age. And I was working till four at the old troubadour, pink sunglasses on like a young Elton John and the cocaine boy. I was a sideshow, so famous, called from the day I was born, blessed with a sick kind of strangeness. I wore like cheap crown of thorns, and every day was an endless parade before the queen of Marina Del Rey. I used to sleep all damn day in a trailer by the bay. I was running from ghosts, half lit and half broke, holding court for the strays. And late Tuesday nights, oh, I'd play open mic. And one time Roseanne Cash walked up to my head and she threw in a fight. I was a sideshow, so famous, called from the day I was born, blessed with a sick kind of strangeness. I wore like a cheap crown of thorns, and every day was an endless parade for the queen of Marina Del Rey. Myself when I needed, though you wouldn't believe it to look at me now. Well, sometimes I flash back to a sleeping bag and a hatchback, a young 20-something who didn't know nothing except how to live fast. Was a fake plastic glitter cachet, but for a moment they all knew my name, and every day was an endless parade for the queen of Marina Del Rey.
This next song is really special to me. I was fortunate enough to get to work with a peer counseling group in high school and college, and I got to meet some really, really amazing young women who had been through a whole lot in their short lives, and I just really admired the way they held themselves, the grace that they went through what they did with, and I wrote this song for them.
He was a bastard, even though he knew his daddy, even had his daddy's angry eyes, brown as the whiskey that ran through both their veins. Turned 18 the day I took his name. I was a young girl, raised up being lonely, and he was the first boy to look my way. My ticket out might have took me straight to hell, but I take some of that blame and I shoulder it myself. Because I saw in him what he saw in me. Crooked family tree. When you got that kind of history, well, it's hard to break free. When broken's all you know, it's all that you know how to be. When life is unkind to mothers and fathers, their sons and daughters often grow up just as hard. We had a baby. No, I loved him dearly. So I saw clearly a choice that must be made. And I hope that family holds him like I couldn't. Was the only way I knew to get him raised, so I wouldn't have to see in him what I see in me. A broken limb from a crooked family tree. When you got that kind of history, well, it's hard to break free. When broken's all you know, it's all that you know how to be. When broken's all you know, it's all that you know how to be. I've been high on a mountaintop, felt like I couldn't stop, just kept soaring. And I've been stuck in that valley where it always seemed cloudy, but I kept on trying. The ups and the downs, the highways and towns, the turns where I kept on finding. The wheels kept turning, oh, my dreams were burning, fire through the ties that were binding. The rainbows I've chased and found no power. The nights that I left you with no one to hold. Oh, you were the one thing I did right back then. Oh, but I'd do it different. if I could do it again. Lying here beside you, I wonder why you put up with my wandering ways, never thinking less of me, 'cause you wouldn't want me anyway but the way that I am. The roads that I've run, feeling more lost than found. The nights that I could have been where I could do it again. Yeah, darling, I'd do it different if I could do it again.
I wrote this next one with my buddies Sonny Sweeney and Ben Chapman.
Is tonight the night I make you a memory? Is today the day I finally forget? Is tonight the night I make you a memory? Is today the day I finally forget? I've been down on my knees, begging you disappear, like the smoke rings off my cigarette. Could this be my golden hour, as the sand finally falling to one side? Will I finally break free from this prison of pain, escape with what's left of my mind? Will I wake up in the morning out of the blue with no warning, where the bad times don't outweigh the good? Stop kicking the embers, finally surrender, and make you a memory the way that I should. Will I wake up in the morning out of the blue with no warning, where the bad times don't outweigh the good? Stop kicking the embers, Lord, help me surrender and make you a memory the way that I should. Yeah, gonna make you a memory. Is tonight the night I make you a memory? Is today the day I finally forget?
Well, thank you all so much for hanging out with me for a little while, and thank you to Ten Penny Gypsy and Big Red Dog Productions for having me today. I'm going to finish with a song. I don't have a lot of love songs in my catalog, but I wrote one for my cowboy boots, because they've always been there with me every step of the way. And about 2 years ago, 2020, I got a phone call saying that the Country Music Hall of Fame would like to feature me in an exhibit. And it was so cool. I mean, I've got to do so many amazing things through music. But that really took the cake. And I've got a picture of me at 16 next to Reba's dress in the Hall of Fame. And they paired me with Reba for the exhibit in the Hall of Fame. So now I got a picture of my outfit next to Reba's outfit in the Hall of Fame. And after the exhibit closed, they called and asked if they could keep some of my stuff for their permanent collection. So my boots have moved on to bigger and better places, but I hope that sometimes they still think of me.
These boots look a little rough, they've seen better days. Hole in the sole and the side stitch in this frayed. But these boots are just like me, stubborn as an old oak tree. Heels dug in and roots run deep, come sunshine or the rain. I picked them up in Colorado. Push the pedal to the metal down this long and winding road. If you want to get to know someone, walk a mile in their shoes. My heart ain't on my sleeve, it's right here in these boots. Well, these boots get kicked off by the door, so they don't track in mud. Don't stay there long, I guess traveling's in my blood. And these boots have tapped along as I watch some heroes sing my songs. Every time I put them on, they fit me like a glove. I finally got to wear them standing on that Opry stage. I walk the streets in Bakersfield with Buck and Haggard play. If you want to get to know someone, walk a mile in their shoes. My heart ain't on my sleeve, it's right here in these boots. So damn hard to hold. The secrets they could tell you, the stories that they know. Well, they won't last forever, good things never do. But I made some real sweet memories right here in these boots. They just scuffed up old brown leather, but man, I love these boots.